Hello, we've got the barbecue out today because of the ever-increasing trend in outdoor cooking. Last year, the UK was actually the largest market within Europe, having over £7 billion spent. Pulled meats have kind of been a large part of that, and pork has certainly led the way, but don't forget about your beef briskets and your lamb shoulders. We've got a beautiful half lamb shoulder in front of me. We're not going to marinate it. We're just going to season it with some salt and pepper and put a little bit of oil on it. If you have one of the marinades to put on your lamb, absolutely. You'll increase your product range and give your shoppers something else to think about. But with this one, all we're going to do is take some vegetable oil, baste this, brush this all over the lamb. It's going to help those seasonings to stick and also just add a nice little bit of extra moisture. Then what we'll do is we'll grab some sea flakes, some sea salt, just pinch those all over, a little bit of freshly ground black pepper as well. There we go. And then we turn it over and we do exactly the same thing on the underside as well, making sure that we season all the way around the meat. There we go. Last little bit of oil and then some more sea flakes. There we go. Some more black pepper, and then this shoulder is ready to go. This is a 1.3 kilo lamb shoulder. It's going to cook at about 170 degrees C, and it's going to take about 4 hours. When you're cooking a large cut of meat on your barbecue, you use a different kind of heat. There's two kinds of heat on a barbecue, direct and indirect. Direct is the kind of heat you'd use if you're doing sausages, burgers, kebabs, steaks. It's where the heat is directly underneath the cooking grate where you put your food. But when you do a roast or a slow cook like a lamb shoulder, you use what's known as indirect heat. And if we look in the barbecue, you'll see that I have a bank of coal in the left-hand side, and then I have nothing in the right-hand side, and that's where we've got our lamb. Underneath the lamb, I've got two trays of water. Pulled meats need a low, slow, moist environment, and the trays of water underneath there will heat up with the barbecue, and they'll help produce steam, so they'll keep this lamb lovely and succulent. So, same way that we check our other meats to make sure that they're cooked, we use a temperature probe. But slightly different to your normal cuts of meat, we actually want to go higher than the 72, 73 degrees C. In order to get meats to pull, we need to go into the 94, 95 degrees C. So if we have a look at this, we're around about 93, 92. Yep, we're gonna be about good for this one. This is going to pull beautifully. What happens at 93, 94 degrees C is that the collagen between the muscle fibers dissolves. So that when you take your forks and you start pulling the pork or the lamb, the muscle fibers just pull apart really easily. We will take this lamb back to our chopping board. Can't wait to get into a bit of that lamb. So, lid back on. And then it's simply a case of shredding the lamb. Look at that. This is absolutely beautiful. And the great thing about a large piece of meat like this on the barbecue is that you have a large number of people over and they can take this and they can put it in pitas, they can take it and put it in wraps, use whichever table sauce they want. Absolutely no problem either way. The simple tips that we've given you, you can hopefully take these and pass them on to your shoppers so that they can create beautiful food on the barbecue in their homes.